Always actively attack after serving errors. Let me explain to you. And then let him explain to everyone how to serve side spin and counter backspin. Why do you keep making mistakes when you have opportunities in the game? Still making mistakes. I'll tell you why. Move the camera over here a bit. Yeah, just like this. You push me in the middle. For example, serving side spin. Opponent pushes back. You anticipated it. Do you see it's the same with you guys? You don't adjust your footwork and gather energy. And the rhythm of hitting the ball. You move and immediately want to hit the ball. It feels like if you don't hit the ball right away, you'll miss the chance. Without adjusting your footwork with small steps, you only know you need to move. But which foot to move? How to move? How to shift your weight over? You think it's enough to just exert force with your hand. This scoring opportunity ends up being a losing point. Can you understand? So this is very crucial. If you all learn this, maybe in your future active attacks, you can at least increase your hit rate to 70-80. In that case, your active attack can put pressure on others. Driving 10 balls and scoring 3, others will give you opportunities directly. You sweat hard, and you still lose. Going back feeling not so good, just exerted force, didn't get on the table. So we need to increase this hit rate to above 70%. What problems are you encountering? The first, your steps are quite chaotic, because when you see an opportunity, you want to hit the ball quickly. You rush to exert force. In the end, your legs and waist don't apply force. You just use your hands to push the ball. You feel like you're exerting force, but you're actually panicking. You don't know how to handle it. Including the other day, we talked about forehand and backhand. Is a common problem among amateurs too, right? You see, the other day we mentioned our offline activity for our course. Everyone played matches. During the matches, I noticed many high balls. Why were they all missed? It's not because of the lack of skill. During practice, the performance was good. The reason is their feet weren't in position. They were moving around randomly, without a systematic movement, without a rhythmic movement. In terms of time, you all have enough time. I take one step and I can be in position. You took three steps. You took two extra steps, but they weren't right. You understand, right? It's chaotic movement. Quite nervous. Also, you didn't realize that your muscles were tense, and your hands were stiff. That's why you all missed. First, calm down. Be calmer. Let me tell you. How to move. First, after you serve. If the opponent only knows how to push. Besides your backhand and forehand positions, there's nowhere else. First need to have the awareness to prepare pivot attack. Then, after the push, how should you move? If it matches your anticipation, don't rush to hit the ball. I'm telling you not to rush to hit the ball. Don't rush to hit the ball. Look, how much time does this ball give you? The ball stays in the air for this long. You have plenty of time. It's not because you're too late. You're just too quick. You're too quick. Your feet aren't even in position yet. Your hands are already out. You have to bring them along. Let them play along with your hands, understand? Watch how I move. When I see the ball coming, I make a positional adjustment with my feet first. While I adjust my position, what do? My right leg. I press down with my leg. And simultaneously, I rotate my waist to prepare for the shot. So when I'm in position, my hand is already relaxed and open, and I can directly hit the ball. At that point, I only need to perform this action. When I see the ball coming, I move my feet first. Move the feet, press the leg, and rotate the waist for the shot. Actually, these actions are done simultaneously. You see, I waited for the ball for so long, so you all have plenty of time. Look how long I waited for the ball. This step. Let me explain it again. This step is not fixed. As soon as the ball is served to my left side, I move like this. I adjust according to the ball. It's completely adequate. Adjust according to the ball. The ball must be within the range of your body, about the width of two fists on either side, always within this range. For example, if the ball is here, I adjust to here. If the ball is here, I move to here. Understand? The opponent's ball speed is fast. First, you have to predict. For a ball like this, if they push it, it won't be too fast. Because you're serving a side top spin, not turning it into Ru Sung Min style shot if you push a faster ball. And the ball is fast like this. It won't be a Ru Sung Min style shot. We have the opportunity to. How to move. Make sure each step is done correctly. You have plenty of time. It's not about being frantic. A single action can wait for the ball for a long time. Often you end up doing several actions, which actually increases the difficulty. Understand? The busier you are, the more chaotic it gets. The more chaotic, the less time you have, and then you hit the ball in a hurry, without waiting for the optimal striking point. Look at those who really know how to play. They play very naturally. Those who don't play well often get more panicked. Those who really know how to loop, if they see this kind of ball, sidestep, then loop, it's just one move. Often those who miss the loop do this. It could be this kind of motion. They're definitely just panicking to hit. So you have to calm yourself down. Calm yourself down first. Being flustered is no use. You just need to get this step right, this step here. This movement. Look, I've sidestepped. I feel it's from your serve receive to your attack, right? You need to have a sense of pause, a sense of rhythm. Never rush to hit the ball before it even bounces, right? No matter what technique, whether it's defense, forehand loop, serve receive, or attack, it's all the same. Come on. So everyone must pay attention to the rhythm.
好，主动抢攻抢到也到位了，会失误。我给你讲这个，然后再让魏哲浩正好让他缓一下，让他给大家讲一下如何这个发侧拳去抢这个下拳。为什么你们在比赛中抢到了还能老是失误？好，我告诉你们为什么。啊，来，
来，大家点一点赞。
把这个镜头往这边来点，或者是、我往我这边来点吧。你看啊，对，来就在这儿就行。你戳我的中间位吧。比如说你们会。一个比如侧拳球，然后跟一个人打，他戳你了，你算住了，你看你们是不是这么想？你们是不是这么想？就是你们没有一个动脚蓄力啊，这么一个出球的一个这种节奏感，你们是直接动完就要出手，就感觉再不出手就来不及了，没有脚下的步伐小步伐的调节，只有动你只知道这要动一下，但是。动哪只脚？怎么去动？怎么把重心带过来？你们不去考虑，你们只感觉我这下我只要手上发上力就行。但往往你们其实这是一个对你们来说是一个得分球，但往往变成了失分球。能明白吧？所以说这个非常关键，真的非常关键啊！大家你们要把这个学会了的话，可能你们在以后的主动进攻当中，最起码能把你的命中率提到70%-80%往上。这样的话你的主动进攻才能给人压力，你说你拉十个球丢仨，不是拉十个球上三个，那你说人家给你拉呗，你看你忙活呗，你累一身汗你还输了，多闹心，回去心情都不太好了，净发力了啊，你没上台，没有实质效果，所以咱得把这个命中率提到70%以上啊。大家看一下啊，你们出现的问题就是什么呢？第一，你们的步伐是比较乱套的，因为你们是看见机会就是戳一个高点，我第一啥，哎呦，机会，就赶紧就要去发力了，然后其实最后你们的腿、脚、腰都没有用上力，只是手去推了一下球，你感觉你发力了，但是其实都没有跟球打到一块儿去，就是一个慌张，啊，不知道该怎么去处理，赶紧出手。你看，包括那天给大家讲的正手与反手业余的通病，是不是也存在这个问题？是吧？你看那天我们说了，我们搞那个课程的线下这个活动，大家去打比赛。打比赛的时候，我发现这么多半高球，为啥全打丢呢？也不是水平不行，平时刚才练的时候都不错呀。为啥呢？脚到不了位， 不是脚到不了位，是你们在乱动，没有说有秩序的去动啊，是有节奏的去动。其实时间你们是完全能来得及的。你想啊，我动一步我就能把球拉上，你们能在那个时候动了三步，你比我们多动两步，但是动的不对，能明白吧？就是乱动，哎，挺紧张啊啊啊！位置也没想到，自己整的浑身肌肉都是僵的，然后手也是僵的，所以说你们全打溜了。就是自己太能忙活了，先让自己沉下来，先把心放下来，先冷静一点。我该怎么动？我告诉大家怎么动。首先，你说你发完球以后，对方如果说，那你看他要是如果只会戳你的话，他除了你的正侧身位就是正手位，那没有别的地方了。你首先你就要有这个侧身的准备意识了，啊，准备意识了。然后戳过来以后呢，应该怎么动？你看我盯完球一看，是的话，我不着急，我不要着急去出手啊，看啊，先不要着急看。我非要着急去出手，不要着急去出手。大家你们看这个球它有多少时间，搭，你看它落地有这么长的时间，你完全来得及，明白吧？来不及是因为你出手太快了，根本不是你来不及，能听懂吗？你出手太快了，脚都没跟上，脚腿没等到位呢，手都出去了啊！你不带他们几个玩，你得把他们几个带上，让他们几个带着手玩，能听懂吧？啊，然后你看啊，看应该怎么动。我看一出完以后，我脚我先进行一个让位，我让位的同时我做什么呢？我腿右腿我持拍腿要往下压住，压住，然后我的手是干嘛？我边压住以后我边转腰去拉手，也就是说我到位的时候我手已经放松的打开了，我就可以直接的去击球了，你就只需要做一个这个动作就可以了啊。看球，转腰压腿拉手，不是先动脚，动脚压腿转腰拉手，其实这是同一时间做完。你看你看，我还等了他半天，所以大家完全来得及，完完全全来得及。你看，看我等，你们看我等了他多少时间？你看过来了，啊，我这一步啊，再跟大家说一下，我这一步不是固定的，说一给我侧身我就这么动，我是要根据这个球来去调整。你看，
对，
完全够用了，
根据这个球来调整，球一定要在身体的，就是。两拳的左右让位，嗯，对，就在始终在这个位置，比如球在这儿，我调到这儿，球在这儿，不是让到这儿，
对，明白吧？回球快呢，那你这个球，你首先你要去预判的呀，你这种球它要戳的话，戳不了太快，因为你是侧上拳，啊，不是说让你练成柳成敏的，你再戳一个，戳快点的，戳快点，这边一戳啊，这个球这么快，然后我，啊，不是让你当柳成敏的啊，哦，对吧？咱们是有机会的情况下去，真正有上手机会的时候，我们去怎么去动，让你把每一步做实了，你是完全来得及的，能明白吧？不是说我去手忙脚乱我就来得及，越手忙脚乱越乱套，本身一个动作可以等球半天，你往往做了好几个动作反倒是加大了这个拉球的困难性，能听懂吗？就是越忙越乱，越乱越来不及，而然后你们还手还先出，完往往就是没有赶到这个等到最佳的这个击球点。其实往往是等啊，等好了，你看真正会拉的人，他打球是很自如的。为什么你们拉不好的人，你看你们是不是比人打球要慌张？真正会拉的人，如果看见一个这种球，哎，一撤拉开手，啪嚓就一下。往往拉丢的人是什么？就可能是这种造型，它不一定是哪种造型，它肯定是就是慌张的出手，所以你们要让自己冷静下来，先让自己静下来，慌张着急是没有用的，你只需要把你这个脚下这个步骤做得熟练一点，你看侧身了，哎呦让，然后我去拉手，
是，嗯，从你的我个人感觉就是从你的接发球到你的进攻到你的防守，对吧，都要有个停顿感，一个节奏感，对吧，一定像就是方老师说的，一定不要着急，等这个球还没跳起来，就不管是什么技术，你的防守也好，正手拉球也好，接发球也好，进攻也好，都是一样的。
来啊！
所以说节奏大家一定要注意啊。